It's early morning, just getting up to go to the gym on Saturday, which is typically every Saturday. Go to the gym and open it up, get a little conditioning workout in before class, do the class. Well, do the class stuff, and then the last few weeks I've been getting a few people together, and we've been doing stuff in open gym, so like three back-to-back sessions, just more skill. Last week was a little bit of weight. We'll see how the body's feeling today and the mind, because I'm exhausted, and from what Ian has planned today, we're doing a really hard workout.
Indoors, a little rabbit. So this, if you know this from one of the other videos, this is where he stays in the kitchen overnight, and then we'll put him out on the carpet for the day because we trust him out there. He's actually been really good, so he stays in here. There's his, does all the stuff. Hey boy.
So this is almost every Saturday morning, unless we go somewhere on a trip. It's just before 7, so try and get here by 7, maybe just before, just so I can stretch and warm up before getting into anything. And then, yeah, train till about 7:50 and jump into class, and then, as I said, usually or sometimes I'll stay after. So big day on Saturdays for me, but it's trying to catch up for stuff from the week that maybe I haven't done, or we've been doing some partner things lately, so introducing some of the people into just big mashups and, you know, those long workouts. So it's been quite fun on the Saturdays. Today we'll see how it goes, though. Still feeling under the weather, so we'll have to see how everything goes. But then I'll go home and do the same thing I've done for almost 5 years again, unless we're on a trip or super, super busy. It's every Saturday I've been FaceTiming my fauna back home, my family. So that'll be carried on today. And oh, lo and behold, there's the flag right behind me. Look at that. Call my family in Canada and see how they're doing today. So that'll be the next thing after I get this training out of the way. That was bad. Especially with the breathing and the stuffed up nose. But that was rowing and skiing. That's so hard. Good thing we don't have bikes yet, because once those get here, it's gonna be worse. The bike at home is fine by itself. I mean, you can still make it hurt. But once you start chucking in multiple cardios and pieces of torture, they're all like torture devices, aren't they? In their own way. It's so hard. So I'll rest for a bit and do my next EMOM, which is more of a skill with some deficit handstands, some L hangs, and something else. I can't read from the board. I forget what I put up there, so. And then I'll rest until class, and then 100 thrusters for time. Every minute on the minute, 5 burpees. Probably won't get any of that filmed, because I'll just be loving life doing that workout. Thank you. 100 thrusters. 100 thrusters every minute on the minute. 100 thrusters every minute on the minute, 5 burpees. RX 61, 24, 53. I hate my life so bad right now. I'll talk about this after when I can breathe. So, 3 or 4 times a week I mix in curls and triceps. I did it for a few weeks, like reps of 50 a day, and it's real hard. I don't have all the stuff or sometimes the time, so cut it back a little bit, but 3 to 4 days a week, buys, tries, mix it up with high volume, high reps, bands, weight, and just dips, push-ups, extensions, different types of curls, bar, dumbbell, kettlebell, and get after it. So usually on Saturdays I'll do like up to 100 or something to make up for a couple of days, and I'll mix up my sets, like 5 sets of something, 5 sets of something else, and it's real good. I feel a bit stronger in my presses, so that's what I'm looking for, is a transfer over in anything. Not gaining really size, I'm not doing it for size. It's not bad to have a gun show. I mean, every dude wants the gun show, don't they? So, yeah. Such a beautiful day. Might go for a walk today. I mean, who wouldn't want to go for a walk on a day like this? Just kidding. It's gonna be a home day for sure. Might get some groceries if we feel like it, or we might just... Well, I might go back into my pajamas after a shower, make some pancakes, and stay in bed all day, because that's the type of day it feels like. Especially after that workout, I am shattered. But definitely finished way better than I thought. 24 and change, 61 kilo, took 2 rests. So I knew I was gonna take 2 to 3, I don't know, 10 rests. Only took 2. Did one after the 6 minutes, that was planned, and then made it all the way into like the 70 something reps, and then rested again, and then was just able to hold on for dear life at the end. So it was real good, real hard. Definitely wanted to try that one. So home day, looking up potential stuff for going to Canada, maybe do some wedding stuff, and yeah, as I said, chatting to the Fano back home, seeing what the parents are doing, what my little bro's doing. He made a CD recently in his music class, so maybe I'll get that as a wedding present. Cute little guy, and then we'll watch some Big Bang, Team Richie, I don't know, maybe a movie, nap, adult nap, love some siestas, and yeah, do nothing today, so what an exciting day as a teacher. Cakes haven't changed. Still doing keto though. Pancakes haven't changed, even though we're doing keto. Look at these. Eggs, cream cheese, a little bit of vanilla, and I'm gonna make a peanut butter topping. And I just add cinnamon for flavor. So no bananas and eggs anymore, just cream cheese and eggs. Get that fat intake up. Look at these places. Queenstown, Toronto. Favorite places in the world, these places. Said we can move to either one and start a life, so we'll see. Maybe one day move to Canada. But at the moment, moving down to Queenstown would probably be the best thing. So fingers crossed we can get that within the next 2 years.